हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर अदिति अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्मसी इन क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस टेक्निक्स. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फार्मास्यूटिक्स टू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. इन दैट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इमल्शन, इंट्रोडक्शन टू बायफेजिक लिक्विड डोसेज फॉर्म्स इमल्शन. एंड इमल्शन इज अ हेट्रोजिनस सिस्टम कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ एटलीस्ट वन एमिसिबल लिक्विड dispersed in the form of droplets diameter that is 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometer is called dispersed phase, and the liquid in which the globules are dispersed is called continuous phase. The two immiscible liquids cannot be dispersed for long period, so an emulsifying agent having the peculiar structure in which one end is hydrophilic and other is lipophilic is used. Because of that, it is possible for emulsifying agent to form a thin film at the interface and reduce the interfacial tension. So let's see about the classification of emulsion. That is, the simple classification is oil in water, O by W type, and water in oil means W by O type. In this oil in water O by W type, we have oil is an internal phase while water acts as an external phase. While in this water in oil type, W means water, which is an internal phase, while oil is an external phase. There are the tests to decide the type of emulsion. There are total four tests, that is the dye test, dilution test, conductivity test, and fluorescence test. So the emulsifying agents can be divided as follows. The emulsifying agents are natural, semi-synthetic, synthetic, inorganic, and alcohols. So in natural, there are two types, vegetable source and animal source. In vegetable, we have gum acacia, tragacanth, agar, pectin, starch, then ureomoss, that is chondrus, and animal source means wool fat, egg yolk, gelatin. Semi-synthetic, methyl cellulose, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose, that is sodium CMC. Synthetic, anionic, cationic, non-ionic, which containing charges. Anionic means containing negative charge, cationic, positive charge, non-ionic, that are chargeless. Inorganic, milk of magnesia, magnesium oxide, magnesium trisilicate, magnesium aluminium silicate, and bentonite. And the alcohols, that is carbovaxes, cholesterol, lecithins. Then emulsions for oral mixture are made with naturally occurring gums as they are inert with the respective therapeutic agent. Acacia is the best emulsifying agent for extemporaneous preparation for oral emulsion and are the stable over a wide range of pH, that is 2 to 10, but they are too sticky for external use. The tragacanth increases the viscosity, however, it is not good emulsifying agent. The monovalent soaps which form O by W, that is oil in water type of emulsion, means in which oil is an internal phase while water acts as an external phase. This O by W type of emulsion are not useful for oral mixture as they cause hemolysis. Preparation of emulsions. The following methods are commonly used for the preparation of emulsions on a small scale, that is dry gum method, wet gum method, bottle method, and other methods. First of all, let's discuss about dry gum method. In this, first of all, we have to measure the required quantity of oil in a dry measure and transfer it into a dry mortar. Then add the calculated quantity of gum acacia into it and triturate so as to form a uniform mixture. Then third one, add required quantity of water and triturate vigorously till a clicking sound is produced and the product becomes white or nearly white due to the total internal reflection of light. The emulsion produced at this stage is known as primary emulsion. Then fourth one, add more of water with the trituration to produce the required volume. Then the following table shows the proportion of oil, water and gum acacia required for different types of oils. Serial number, type of the oil, example, ratio of oil as to water as to gum. So first of all, fixed oil, example, castor oil, almond oil, arachis oil, cod liver oil, the ratio of oil as to water as to gum is 4 as to 2 as to 1. Second, volatile oil, that are turpentine oil, peppermint oil and cinnamon oil, ratio of oil has to water has to gum is 2:2:1. Third one, mineral oil, liquid paraffin, ratio of oil has to water has to gum is 3:2:1. Then wet gum method, second method of preparation of emulsion is wet gum method. In this method, the proportion of oil has to water to gum for preparing the primary emulsion is the same as given in the table. Calculate the quantity of oil, water and gum required for preparing the primary emulsion. Then powder the gum acacia in a mortar, add water and triturate it with gum as to form mucilage. Then third one, add the required quantity of oil in the small portion with the rapid trituration until a clicking sound is produced, and the produce it will becomes white or nearly white. At this stage, the emulsion is known as primary emulsion. Then fourth one, add more of water in small portion to the primary emulsion with the trituration to produce the required volume of uniform emulsion. And fifth one, transfer the emulsion to a bottle, cork it, label and submit. Then third one, bottle method. Bottle method is used for the preparation of emulsions of volatile and other non-viscous oils. This proportion of oil as to water as to gum is 2:2:1. Measure the required quantity of the oil and the transfer into a large bottle. Add required quantity of powdered gum acacia. Then second one, shake the bottle vigorously until the oil and gum are mixed thoroughly. Third one, add the calculated amount of water all at once. Then fourth one, shake the mixture vigorously to form a primary emulsion. Fifth one, add more of water in a small portions with the constant agitation to produce the required volume. Then recommended container, screw capped plain bottles. Special labeling instructions are shake well before use as it is a liquid dosage form. Then NMRs, these are the solutions, suspensions or oil in water emulsions of medicaments intended for rectal administration. Container is a single-use plastic pack with the rectal nozzle. So in next session, we will see about the experiments. Experiment number 32. The title of this experiment is to prepare and submit emulsion containing castor oil 10 ml. Formulation of emulsion for internal use. The learning objectives are to understand the use and preparation of the emulsion by wet gum method, and second one, ability to prepare the emulsion carefully so that it is stable. Apparatus required are mortar, pestle, measuring cylinder, pipettes, beaker. Factor calculated as quantity required upon quantity given is equal to 10 upon 120, that is equal to 0.083. Prescription. The formula given is in the Latin terminology. So we have to convert that Latin terminology, means that is given in the imperial system. We have to convert it into the metric system. So we have this oli ricini means castor oil, which is ounce I. Aquam cinnamoni means cinnamon water, add ounce IV means ounce 4. So let's see the formula table. Type lags of this type, translation, quantity given in the imperial system for preparing 120 ml, quantity given in the metric system to prepare 120 ml, and quantity taken in the metric system to prepare 10 ml. So we have first castor oil, which is used as a laxative. Quantity given in imperial is ounce I, so that means 30 into 1 30 ml. So for preparing 10 ml, the quantity taken should be 2.5 ml. This quantity should be calculated according to the factor. Second, cinnamon water, which is used as a vehicle. Quantity given in the imperial system, add ounce IV means 30 into 4, that is 120 ml, which is quantity given in the metric system, and quantity taken in the metric system is quantity sufficient to prepare 10 ml. Then third one, acacia. It is used as an emulsion stabilizer. The quantity is not given in the imperial system, but in the metric system, that is a quantity sufficient. And as we know, the quantity taken in the metric system should be up to the 0.2 gram. Direction, 1 tablespoonful to be taken 4 times a day. So now let's move towards actual performing of experiment in laboratory. So this is acacia. As emulsifiers, emulsion stabilizer, we have to use this acacia in the preparation. Then this is a castor oil, which is the main API, and this is purified water. So we will previously weigh this castor oil into this beaker. So now, and this is previously weighed acacia, and this is purified water. So this emulsion is prepared by wet gum method. So first of all, we have to take this acacia gum into this water pestle. Then we will going to add purified water into it. As this is wet gum method, so we have to properly emulsify this gum with the help of water, and then we will going to add castor oil into it. But first of all, we will triturate it properly. So now, after proper trituration, we will going to add this castor oil into this previously triturated mixture of acacia and water. Then again we will going for proper trituration of it into this mortar pestle. So after trituration, we are going to pour our formulation, prepared formulation, into this measuring cylinder for volume makeup. After making the volume, now we will pour it into this container, and then we will proceed for labeling part. Now we will move towards labeling of this formulation. Labeling of formulation, emulsion 10 ml, for ABC, that is name of patient, register number XYZ, which is the number given in the register, dispensed by PQR, is name of pharmacist, manufacturing date September 2020, storage condition, storing cool and dark place. This is reverse direction for external use only. One more direction, as this is a liquid dosage form, so shake well before use. Manufactured by Element Pharmacy Nasik. Result: the 10 ml of this emulsion is submitted in this amber colored bottle for inspection with special instruction on label as shake well before use. Thank you.